हेलो हेलो हेलो, वेलकम दोस्तों, वेलकम। सो टुडे वी हैव अ शॉकिंग ब्लंडर फ्रॉम ग्रैंड मास्टर अली रेज़ा फ़िरोज़ा, हु ब्लंडर्ड इन अ वेरी एलिमेंट्री किंग एंड पॉन एंड गेम एंड वेंट डाउन फाइटिंग टू वर्ल्ड चैंपियन मैग्नस कार्लसन। थैंक्स टू दिस ब्लंडर, मैग्नस हैज नाउ वन हिज 10th टाइटल ऑफ 2020, एंड व्हाट अ ईयर दिस हैज बीन फॉर द वर्ल्ड चैंपियन। आई मीन, to think of it, even we could have had the world championship, but it has now been postponed to next year. So this is a position from their game in the penultimate round. Firuja had just been overtaken by Magnus in the standings for of Norway Chess, the first super tournament involving Carlsen that happened after over 6 months of inaction for over the board chess. So let's quickly jump into the position. This looks like a fairly simple end game where white should hold this to a draw. And just to give you an idea that Magnus had been pushing throughout. So we had a double minor piece end game, but the bishops were of opposite colors. So we had a bishop trade a bit earlier around at this point. And then now in this position, Carlsen has been pushing throughout as black. And it has just been not going for him, as Firuja has been tenaciously defending the position. And even here, this looks, I mean, very close to a draw. But Magnus Carlsen, being the champion that he is, pushes on, keeps fighting, and he plays on till bare kings in most of his games. And now you see why. So after King G3, seeing there is no way further for Magnus here, he goes for knight into h5, but please remember that he had been pushing throughout. So Magnus had about 35 minutes on his clock, whereas Firuja was under less than a minute. And it felt very difficult for Firuja until this point. But here, probably, I assume he took it very lightly, thinking, okay, it's just a draw. So today, guys, we'll be learning a very simple rule, the rule of opposition in chess, the opposition where kings are in front of each other. So let's go. So knight h5, bishop h5, king h5. Now white plays the correct move, that is king h3, and you can see there is an opposition. So wherever the black king goes, the white king just follows. It's very important to note that just the color of the position, the color of the position of the kings should be the same. So you can see king h6, king h4. Again, now they are both on black squares, and Firuja follows this perfectly. For a few moves before he cracks. So let's continue. King g7, again king g3. See, this is known as distant opposition, which is very important in today's times, where there is socially distanced opposition here, guys. And king f8, Firuja smartly plays king f2. Again, this is a longer version of the distant opposition I was talking about. King e7. Now here, I think Firuja makes a slight inaccuracy. You won't check it by the engine, but it's a fundamental inaccuracy, guys. He should have played king to e3, again limiting. You see the opposition, I was talking about the colors. And instead of king e3, which follows the black square and the black square, he goes for king e2. Now it is, he just makes it difficult for himself. And Carlsen, being very smart, he plays king to e8. Now this is a very important move, because the person who always has the opposition decides the game, as we will see at the end. So now Carlsen has taken the opposition, because he was the last player to move into opposition. So after king e3, now again Carlsen, being Carlsen, tries to squeeze water from stone, and just is trying his little bit to put even more pressure. And Firuja is just trickling down to his last few seconds, and you can see he does make the fatal blunder very soon. So king d3, king d6. Now he wants to enter via this square into white's camp. And here, guys, can you spot white's only move in this position? Because of Firuja's inaccuracy alert, now white has only one move. Can you find it? And yes, if you guys said king c3, king e3, or king c4, I think then all of them lose. Even king c2 and king e2. The only move is the social distant. We are in these times, so important to be socially distant, even for the kings. And king d2 was the drawing move, maintaining the social distance. And if black goes king c5, now only now we go king c3, and there is now we have taken the opposition as white, and Firuja would have saved this game. Instead, Firo played king c3 and Carlsen just plays king c5. Now if you go to king b3, white is lost because the king enters. And now if you go king d3, now the black king enters via this, like squeezing him along the rank, and it is just over again. And please note, in that critical position, if some of you had suggested king c4, even this loses, because now Carlsen can go the other way. This is what probably Firuja missed in his calculations and paid heavily. Because king c3, now you can't simply go king c5 because of f5 that loses. And now you just get a passed pawn, and now your king is far more ahead. And after king e6, if you come back with your king, and now king f7 is the move. As you can see, he is not in time to complete the opposition. And now king h5 is the move that wins. And after king g3, king g5, it's the same position that we had on the queen side. So guys, this is a position that would haunt Firuja for some time. But Magnus Carlsen, again, winning a game, winning a tournament, and proving why he's the world champion. We will also put in a link at the end in the description for you guys to check that out. A special lesson on oppositions on chess.com. And meanwhile, let's join in to congratulate Magnus Carlsen for another classical win in 2020. What a player, what a champion. See you guys.